Welcome back to Bloom. It's time again for Ask the Dietitian, where I, the dietitian, answer your nutrition-related questions. Today's question comes from Renee, who lives in Denver but watches when she's here for work and says she loves junk food, but she knows she needs to cut back. Can I help? Well, Renee, I can help, but at the end of the day, it's up to the person, you, to make those good food choices. But it can be hard because our environment is saturated in calories. Cheap, tempting, unnecessary calories. That's why we call them junk food. You can't run errands or take a trip to the mall without dealing with a constant barrage of junk food, and the temptation isn't all your fault. Unfortunately, human brains aren't designed to say no to all this temptation. So it does our health no favors. Thanks a lot, brain. But if you want to cut back on all that delicious junk food you see behind me, here are some strategies you can use to resist the flood of junk food fighting for your attention. First, don't let yourself get too hungry, or hangry as it could be known. If you're too hungry, your body will actually work against you and tell you that you need treats. Yes, your gut signals the reward system in your brain that you really need to be on the lookout and respond intensely to any food cues you see. So that means your brain is rationalizing that yummy smelling cinnamon bun that you regret later. So how do you fight that? Well, I say to always keep snacks on hand, especially when traveling. He helps to have a healthy snack so your body can get those calories without craving something else. Next, don't drink your calories. Really keep a watch on sugary drinks like soda, sports drinks, energy drinks, or sweetened teas because they lead to weight gain. Yes, they have extra calories that add up in your daily intake, but another reason they could be as bad is that liquid calories may not register. So if you drink 500 calories, it's not gonna feel the same as if you ate 500 calories, thus meaning you might eat more on top of that. People eat only slightly less food when they drink a 150 calorie glass of soda with lunch than when they have a zero calorie glass of water. So when you can, definitely skip the high calorie drinks. Next, find foods that don't cause war. And I mean war with yourself. That, oh, look at those cookies so-and-so brought. I can have a cookie, but I'm just gonna have half. Do you ever only eat half? No, again, we're human. So when you are hungry between meals, try a good nutritious snack that won't leave you at war with yourself feeling like you can't eat it all or feeling guilt. Something like fresh fruit or carrots with hummus. The point is that try to identify foods that you still enjoy, but you know are better for you and they're not gonna cause an intense internal struggle. I'm only gonna have one bite of this, but oh gosh, I want more. That's exhausting, and the willpower parts of our brain can only take so much. I know, because behind me in our office is an entire buffet of fries, and it's very hard to walk by and not wanna try one. So again, avoid the foods that make you go to war with yourself. Don't make your mind and your willpower work so hard. Another way to help your junk food cravings is to address your stress. Stress can be a huge cue. Notice that emotional triggers that can set you up to crave palatable, rewarding foods. Instead of reaching for food or soothing your stress with chips, go for a walk, call a friend, try some meditation, or distract yourself. Make this a habit. The craving will peak and then go down, and you won't give in to it. Similar to stress, you can slow down your body's request for tasty foods by getting enough sleep. When researchers let people sleep only 4 hours a day, 4 hours a night for 5 days, they ate more and gained weight. And in similar studies, participants reported increased hunger and their appetite was greatest for high carbohydrate or high fat foods. Finally, give yourselves a break. Have some compassion because it is hard to always eat right and avoid temptation. Our food environment is set up to make it hard, so make your best steps towards eating healthy and give yourself a break when you can. Stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back with more Bloom.